Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. This is Naveen. In this video, I'm just come up with a new example of CSS transformation. So let's have a look how this works. So I have an image. I just cut like an image. So when I hover on this image, it's gonna slide like this. So image is sliding whenever I hover on it. Okay, so these type of examples you might have seen in most of the websites, like if you want to develop any real world application, so where you can see a cards like this. So by default, some image will be displayed, and when you hover on this, the description will be slightly just sliding it. Okay, so let's see how to make this example live. Okay, so now let's start coding. So I have open WebStorm, so I need to create a folder. So I create right click new directory 07 underscore CSS underscore image slide on hover. Okay, so inside I need to have one image, one HTML and one style.css. So I create new HTML something index, and I create a new style sheet style.css. I need an image. I have already downloaded. It's on my desktop. Copy and paste it here. Okay, so now let me open index.html. Let me write, change the title. Let's say image slide on hover. Next, I write link tag to connect the style sheet, style.css. Let's make a division. So let's make a structure first, and then we'll start the styles. Give the class called container. The parent division is called container. Inside, I write an image src woman.jpg. Let's make some alter, this empty, and let's make a division with the class called contenter. Inside, I write a paragraph, just say lorem, some 25 tab, some 25 dummy words. Okay, so this is a structure of this example: container, one image and one content and some text. So let's check. Let me open this over here. Yes, I got an image and some text also. Done. So let's convert this like this. Okay, so container. So let me go to style.css dot container. I say border. So border something 10 pixels, solid and red color. I got a border, and I had to reduce the width and height of this. So I say width some 300 pixels, and the height, I make the height some 450 pixels. Okay, but image is not fit inside of the box. So you can do dot container space image. I say width inherit, and also the height inherit. Okay, it fits, and I want this box to be center of my page. So you can do a margin auto, and I want to give some space about the card as well. Let's make some 100 pixels and auto. Yes, looks good. And I don't need the border now, so let me just say remove the border. And let's make some rounded image and this border radius. So border radius, some 10 pixels, but image is not apply. Let me copy, paste here. Done. Let's make some box shadow. Box shadow is box shadow 0, 5 pixels, 10 pixels, and the black I give for the parent. So let me copy or cut this. Keep it here. Done. Now this, save it. Now check, you got some border radius. Fine. And this one, this text, I want to give some colors, and even this text has to fit here, right? So let's make some styles over here. What you do is, yeah, for the parent I'll give the position relative. And for this text, I want to be a position absolute and stick to the bottom of my image. So I say dot container space dot content. contents. I write position absolute, and let's make at bottom zero position. Okay, it's a bottom 0%. Yeah, fine. So let me change the color and all. Let's say background linear gradient, some 45 degrees, comma blue violet, and some deep pink color. Fine. Let me change the text color. Color white. Font family. I say font family Arial and sans serif. Let me give some space around. That's a padding. So padding some 10 pixels. Okay, looks good. Let me increase the font size a bit. You can write only content now. Okay, right here only. So font size some 18 pixels. Yep, looks good. And see, actually how this application has to work is when I hover, it has to slide like this. Okay, so you want to make that this text has to come little below the image. So I do one thing, bottom 40% I'll make. Oh, sorry, it's a minus 40%. Yes, it is in the bottom of my actual image. Okay, so whenever I hover, so dot container colon hover, then the content I want it to be a bottom 0%. So minus 40% to the 0% is move on. Yes, it's moved, but it's very faster. You want to make it slowly. There is something called transition all 0.5 seconds. So half second time duration movement is going to happen. So now let's check. Yes, it's working. But what about the image? Image is not sliding. If you want to make the image to slider, you can go with translate Y. For image, I say first, do one thing directly when you hover. So I write here dot container colon hover, then the image to be transform translate Y some minus 40% to above it has to move. So let's say, okay, but it's very fast, sir. You want to make it slowly. Let's make some transition all 0.5 seconds. Now save it, go check. Yes, it is perfectly moving like this. But thing is, I don't need to see this overflow. So you can do to parent elements. Let's say overflow hidden. So you can hide the overflow effects. Now let's check. Is gonna be like this. Okay, fine. And anything else? Yeah, let me give you see slightly here rounded corner is not looks good. So border radius not rounded. I delete this property for image. So one second. Yeah, I remove this rounded corner. So let's say, yes, it's perfectly working over here. And you want, you can reduce this to some 455. It's more, but yes, perfect. If I say 455 height, so it's gonna be the perfect and there's no gap at all. Yes, it's perfectly works. And even you want to give some background color for the whole body, you can give body background color some dark slate gray color. Okay, let's check. So now you got an image. So whenever I hover on the image, so I got some text has been sliding. So this is the previous example and we have made this example. Okay, so that's it, enough for this video, and thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe to our channel, and I'm just gonna come up with a new videos very soon. Thank you.